Hey everybody, it is March 22nd, it's Thursday. The weather is beautiful here in Toronto, Ontario. Clear skies, which is great for painting. It's kind of the early morning around 9. It's my favorite time to paint as the sun gets up. It's not too bright and you can see all the colors. So today right now I'm back to work on this raccoon painting. I started drawing in some of the details in the background. So the deal is this raccoon has been in the kitchen and he's been rummaging and opening up the pantry and nibbling on everything. He's been making quite a big mess here in the kitchen. Here's an oven. I want to put something in here. I don't know what yet. So if you have any ideas of what this big raccoon could be roasting in the oven, let me know. And so because this painting is so big, I'm able to add a lot more detail than my other raccoon painting. So I decided to open up the fridge here, and some vegetables he's been nibbling on has spilled out. There's a lot of architectural work here, so I can go over my rulers. So this is my meter stick. I use it for the big long lines, like in the kitchen tiling. It helps to get the straight line right across the canvas there. And then I have my foot long metal ruler. It's better for some of the shorter lines, especially in the kitchen here. You know, you can just turn it around with one hand instead of trying to fling around a meter stick all over. You don't want to hit anyone or yourself, safety first. And this is one of my favorite rulers. It is the right angle ruler. I got it at Currie's at Dundas and University. It's about, I don't know, 13 bucks-ish. And it's great. I love this ruler because it's got measurements of inches and centimeters. It's got all these tiny little squares, so if you want to make a right angle, let's say I want to make, you know, these lines for my blinds, I want to make them a right angle to the windowsill here, so I just match up the left side here, and away I go. Look at all those right lines I can make, and it's because of these little markings all over, I can make different thickness lines here, making sure they're all parallel. It's so handy when you want to draw more architectural things on the fly. It is wonderful. And when I'm drawing, you know, you draw a bunch of lines and you think, oh, I don't know if I like this line there, so I draw another one and another one and another one. And because graphite is so hard to erase from canvas, I'll just use some white paint to cover up my mistakes, just so I can get a clear space, so I can start thinking about it and seeing it in the painting. So here, for example, I drew two tile lines. One of them is correct, the other is wrong. Can you guess which one? I think I'm actually gonna erase this one. And so that's it for now, and then later I'll be turning the painting upside down to try and do some of the ceiling lines. They're not quite straight, they're just sketches there. And that's it for now. I will see you later.